में इच्छा शक्ति के परिचायक हैं। मित्रों, अब वह क्षण आ गया है जिसके लिए हम सब यहाँ एकत्र हुए हैं। मैं माननीय उपराष्ट्रपति जी से आग्रह करता हूँ कि कृपया लोकतंत्र, राजनीति और धर्म तथा डेमोक्रेसी, पॉलिटिक्स एंड गवर्नेंस पुस्तकों का लोकार्पण करने का अनुग्रह करें। धन्यवाद माननीय उपराष्ट्रपति जी। अंग्रेजी की कुछ प्रतियां और हिंदी की कुछ प्रतियां बाहर उपलब्ध हैं, आप जब जाएंगे तो वो एक एक मानार्थ प्रति अपने साथ लेके जा सकते हैं। अपनी सरलता और सौम्यता के लिए विख्यात माननीय श्री एम वेंकैया नायडू जी भारत के 13वें उपराष्ट्रपति और राज्यसभा के सभापति हैं। छात्र जीवन से ही सक्रिय राजनीति में आए माननीय वेंकैया जी ने राष्ट्रीय राजनीति में शिखर को छुआ। वे अटल जी की सरकार में मंत्री रहे, भारतीय जनता पार्टी के राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष रहे। उपराष्ट्रपति बनने से पूर्व वे माननीय नरेंद्र भाई की सरकार में अनेक मंत्रालयों के मंत्री रहे और सफलतापूर्वक सभी दायित्वों का निर्वहन किया। अपनी वाक्पटुता और वन लाइनर्स के लिए वे विख्यात हैं। अपनी विशिष्ट शैली और ओजपूर्ण वक्तव्य से वे सबको मंत्रमुग्ध कर देते हैं। मैं उनसे विनम्र आग्रह करता हूँ, कृपया आएँ, हमारा मार्गदर्शन करें। माने रहेंगे
श्री ए सूर्यप्रकाश जी, ऑथर ऑफ दिस बुक एंड वन ऑफ माय गुड फ्रेंड्स, श्री एस गुरुमूर्ति जी, एडिटर, कमेंटेटर एंड हु हैज टेकन द रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ रनिंग द तुगलक न्यूज़पेपर after Cho's demise, Sri Prahlad Joshi, Kendriya Mantri, Sri Anurag Singh Thakur, Kendriya Mantri, Sri Arjun Ram Meghwal, Kendriya Mantri, Sri Rajiv Chandrasekhar, Kendriya Mantri, Sri Rajwardhan Singh Rathod, Member of Parliament, Sri Nupendra Misra Ji, Chairman, Nehru Memorial Museum and Library, श्री राम माधव अमित करे जी, प्रभात कुमार जी और अन्य मित्रों, आई एम रियली हैप्पी टू सी गैलेक्सी ऑफ पीपल फ्रॉम वेरियस वॉक्स ऑफ लाइफ वी हैव कम टू पार्टिसिपेट इन दिस प्रोग्राम। टुडे is the Constitution Day, and this morning we commemorate the 72nd anniversary of the adoption of the Constitution of India. This day in 1949, at an event at the Central Hall of Parliament. I am indeed happy that the release of two books authored by Dr. Surya Prakash titled Democracy, Politics and Governance in English and Loktantra, Rajniti and Dharma in Hindi is scheduled to coincide with such a solemn occasion. Initially, I advise Surya Prakash to have the program on some other day because Constitution Day, Central Hall of Parliament, and then President, Vice President, Prime Minister, all of us are there in that function. I told him that he may not get required publicity. He said, no sir, I am more concerned about the occasion. Today also is the concluding day of the Asian European amid that SM meeting also. I was there in that meeting. There were a number of other important functions, but the timing of the release of this program, book, is befitting because he has spent a lifetime analyzing the functioning of our parliamentary institutions and the constitutional framework that guides our public life, and polity and amplifying the messages that flow from the same for wider dissemination and sensitization. At the outset, I compliment the author for the passion, purpose, perspective and perseverance that marked his 50 years long career as a journalist to start with and as a commentator later. Dr. Surya Prakash ji exemplifies these attributes of an ideal journalist through his relentless pursuit of excellence combined with ethical standards. Excellence, ethical standards. I have reasons to believe that it has been meaningful and satisfying mission for him on account of his contribution on record and their impact on all the concerned stakeholders, including the reading public. See, Surya Prakash ji was totally objective as a journalist, keeping the news and views separate. The biggest problem is today, people combine news and views. And they try to project their views as the news. Keeping the news and views separate and leaving the judgment to the people. You can make commentary, undoubtedly. You can make analysis. He passionately pursued his perspective-laden views as a commentator later. These four P's that I referred to should guide any journalist and commentator. After his entry into journalism in 1971 with the Indian Express in Bengaluru and his relocation in New Delhi in 1981, and as a commentator over the last 3 decades, Surya Prakash has pursued the mission of serving the larger public cause by extensively reporting and writing on the functioning of various institutions with the sole purpose of nudging them to raise the bar. My sense is that imposition of the emergency just 4 years after his debut as a journalist and the attendant scares that he personally underwent and witnessed resolved him to focus on the rights and dignities and duties of citizens and to ensure that the nation's march is guided by the philosophy outlined in the Constitution. His respect for the truth and his respect for and the commitment to the constitutional principles comes out as a defining principles of his 50 long years of his mission. He has taken up this as a mission with all the passion for the sake of the nation. He never gave any omission or any remission or did not expect any commission. He performed his responsibilities with passion for the nation. That's where people admire Surya Prakash ji. There are very few who can match such single-minded pursuit of Surya Prakash ji with such determination and clarity of thought and purpose. The two books that I am releasing today, have released, chronicles the trends and temptations that marked our public life over the last 30 years, bringing out the attendant concerns and flagging the required correctional interventions. These books are of great value as ready reckoners to understand the shortcomings in the functioning of our constitutional and parliamentary institutions and the aberrations triggered by short-sighted persons in power and authority. what marks the works of Sri Surya Prakash is the intense research and following evidence that he marshals in support of his arguments. Because information is very vital. But information with confirmation is more than an ammunition. He is known for it. His book, What Ails Indian Parliament, published 26 years ago, is a clear proof of such an approach of Sri Surya Prakash Ji, which brought out the shortcomings in the functioning of our apex legislature, with a huge body of statistics, perhaps for the first time. Another unique contribution of Sri Surya Prakash Ji is his strong defense of Indian nationalism, which our constitution seeks to foster. Amidst growing domestic and international efforts to run down the cause of nationalism and even our vibrant democracy, he has been coming out with effective counter-narratives, basing his arguments on the demonstrated core values of the country and the philosophy of our constitution. Friends, I want to share with you, we are all seeing a trend, particularly in the Western media, to run down India. Run down the government and then portray India in a poor light. They are not able to digest the fact that India is on the move. India is on the rise. India is being recognized and respected once again worldwide, which was known as Vishwaguru. Is again getting into that prominence. So they try to really portray India in a negative sense. This effort has been going on. As I told you, they don't think, they don't digest our eminence. And then they want to run down the country, some of them, because they are not able to digest. Some of them are suffering with the problem of indigestion. And there is no counter-effective from our country. They run down our country on freedom of expression, freedom of press, and also on the issue of secularism. India, according to me, my own study, is the most secular and real country in the world. You don't find any country. The people who talk of secularism, you know, they are guided by a book, their own book of their choice. Whereas here, everybody, irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion, and region, they are all being respected and recognized. There are instances of individual there, here and there. But country as a whole, we practice, because secularism is within the blood, nerves and veins of Indian people, not because of this government or that government. It's because it is in the blood of Indian people. Sarva dharma samabhavana. Respecting all the religions is our age-old practice. Sarve jana sukhino bhavantu. Vasudhaika kutumbakam. Share and care is the core of Indian philosophy. And they try to run down us, portray us, freedom of religion. I suggest to them that they should look inward, inwards. What is happening in their countries, so-called democracies. We are the largest parliamentary democracy. We have democracy since ages in our system, from the Janapas and all. As I told you, we believe in peaceful coexistence. Second, freedom. You have such a freedom here, you can write stories like that. Suppose if this Prime Minister dies, story, I am not mentioning it, then who will be the alternative? That also some writers wrote in this country. And also so much freedom to attack Prime Minister, to attack everything. I don't think there is any parallel to this. Everybody has got right to criticize, and some of it, as Guru was telling about social media, is getting perverted presentation before the people. And our constitution is flexible. And our people, from time to time, whenever we thought, we were willing to take suggestions, share experiences, go by the success stories, and amend our constitution also. And we have such a freedom that you can adore and admire and do puja of any god. There is no dearth of gods and goddesses. Or you can also have the free, you also have the freedom that you yourself, you can think, I am the god. No problem. That also is accepted in this country. That is the greatness, beauty of the dharma of this land. And some people are now trying to teach us lessons. And we never attacked any country, in spite of civilizational values, in spite of so much growth. Before independence, Guru wrote a beautiful article in one of the speeches I heard him about India's wealth. All the other small countries, they came, they ruled us, ruined us, looted us, cheated us also, some of them. Colonial mindset is not there, it's not acceptable to us. That is the greatness of this nation. And we have elections every 5 years, peaceful elections, here and there small incidents may be there, but of such a large country, 130 crore population, conducting elections, our election commission, the system that has been evolved, is really great. There is no parallel anywhere in the world. And then the country is moving like this. As I told you, some of the people are not able to digest it. But there is every need to counter effectively by presenting truth, even to the Western media. Whether they will publish it or not, we leave it to their judgment. But the facts has to be shared. And Surya Prakash Ji has been effectively doing it. I am very happy on that account, that international media, Western media, what is being reported, report without any support, he counters it effectively with facts and figures. This is where the country is very happy about Sri Surya Prakash Ji's performance. The core argument of Surya Prakash Ji is that our constitution has clearly set the rules of the game, and all the stakeholders should abide by those rules with unflinching commitment. He brings out in clear terms that our democracy, despite some shortcomings, conforms to such principles, and in confirmation of such principles, no one needs to give us any certificate in this regard. In the process, he brings out the democratic fervor that guides us. These rightist thinkers in our country who have been under constant attack from the so-called left thinkers who have dominated the national psyche for too long. I don't want to get into this politics. I always believe you don't be a rightist or a leftist, be straight. That is sufficient. Being an Indian, nothing but being guided by the constitutional principles of equality and justice for all and the spirit of fraternity, which is the hallmark of every nationalist, raising above the divisions of caste, creed, color, region and religion. So Surya Prakash Ji has been pursuing this mission, and I compliment him for the same. Every Indian needs to take pride from our past and march forward with confidence and commitment to realize new India of the dreams of freedom fighters and of the vision of the framers of our constitution, so as to realize the aspirations of young India. I'm happy to note this, that Surya Prakash ji did his bit in this regard through his published works. I am aware that Sri Surya Prakash ji has been instrumental in introducing the live telecast of parliamentary proceedings committee system in 1993. His study of Bundestag, the German parliament, and his report thereof played a key role in these two momentous decisions, which was acknowledged by the then Speaker of the Lok Sabha, Sri Sivaraj Patil. I appreciate Sri Surya Prakash for his role in them. I am indeed happy to release the two books Sri Surya Prakash ji has written on this particular occasion of the Constitutional Day today. I am also happy to note that large number of dearer and nearer ones of Surya Prakash ji are here today as a measure of your acknowledgement and support to the mission he has been pursuing over the last 50 years. No doubt, this is a great moment of joy to share for all of you. I also compliment all of you for standing by him all these years. I am sure Sri Surya Prakash ji will continue with his mission for many more years to come. Thank you. Namaskar. Jai Hind.
हार्दिक आभार माननीय उपराष्ट्रपति जी, आपने भारत के ऊपर हो रहे प्रहारों के बारे में चिंता प्रकट की, परंतु भारतीय जनमानस में इतनी शक्ति है कि वो इन प्रहारों का प्रतिकार कर सकेगा। आज के समारोह के